Hotel de Paris.
The message read, Timothy Flight, the ancient enemy.
I know what some of you are thinking. You're thinking, Matt, phantoms? Really? But you know what? I don't care. Ben Affleck was bombing phantoms, yo!
Word, bitch. Phantoms like a motherfucker.
What's up now?
They walked in there and they did. It was closed. They couldn't find a place. Couldn't find a place to get in. So they had to go around this scary spot right here. It is scary right there. They went in this alley right here. It was very scary.
There's a lot of ghost stories in this town, in Georgetown.
We are in historic Georgetown today, folks. An old historic town way up in the mountains of Colorado, almost 9,000 feet up in the mountains. It's cold tonight, and we're here at nighttime. We're gonna film a few of the locations. Lots of movies filmed here. Clint Eastwood filmed a movie here, Any Which Way But Loose. Right at this sign here, Clint Eastwood drove right underneath that sign. And what else? Ooh, Ben Affleck, yo. The Phantom movie is called Phantoms. If you've never seen Phantoms, that movie was filmed here. Ben Affleck was the bomb in Phantoms, yo!
Word, bitch. Phantoms like a mall.
What's up now? So it's gonna be fun. It's cold, folks. Put on your hats and mittens and join me for this episode of Matt's Rad Show!
So here is downtown area of Georgetown.
Another cool fun fact about this area is that, of course, being up in the Rocky Mountains, it was the perfect place for John Denver to film a few Christmas episodes and a Christmas movie. So those were filmed up here too, all in this area here. So it's pretty cool. A lot of film history here.
Georgetown looks like where you were born.
Look at these places up here, folks. It's old little, whatever that is. Such a cool little town. Cool little mountain town, man. Oh no, they got a light in there. Somebody must be fixing it up. It's an old schoolhouse. Old school. Used to be abandoned, but I think they're restoring it, so that's cool.
This is cinematic history, folks. Here's the house. From Phantoms, yo!
But Affleck was the bomb in Phantoms.
Ooh, scary. Yeah. She looks around and she sees some of these houses here. And she sees that house. I think she sees that house. Looks over here. Maybe looks at this. This is the house at the beginning of the movie that they come to, and it's empty, and she finds her grandmother like dead in like the oven or something like that. Anyway, this is the house. Ooh, scary stuff. The only reason I filmed this, of course, is because it was such an epic movie.
Word, bitch. Phantom's like a motherfucker.
I think there's a shot where it's way up high. They must have put a crane over by this tree, and they filmed it from way up high. Her, like, walking through here. Oh, owners have just got home, and I'm filming the front of their house. I'm sure they love it. So here we are. And I must say, I have to admit something, folks. Let you know just a little secret about Matt here. At Phantoms, it's kind of a guilty pleasure of mine. I've seen Phantoms probably more times than I care to admit. I think I like the movie Phantoms, though, just because I've been to Georgetown so much, and I love Georgetown. But it's a cool little movie. It's not bad, you know? For those of you who have seen the movie Phantoms, you'll remember there was a manhole that the thing, the evil kind of creature that they were trying to find, was hiding in. Down beneath the earth, the horror came from below. And there's a manhole up here I want to check out, because that's where the thing kind of came up from out of the ground, and he took on the shape and the form of the entire town. So that was supposed to be like the scary part, and where the being kind of showed himself, and then all the people kind of bound together in this big blob kind of thing. It was really kind of a weird ending, but it was still pretty cool. Okay, yeah, here it is, dude. Here's the manhole. Check it out. They put a light down that manhole right there. There it is. The manhole from Phantoms. Dun, dun, dun.
Your witness.
I'm probably the only person in the world that would do an episode on Phantoms. But you know what? Ben Affleck was the bomb in Phantoms, yo! Phantoms. So yeah, right about here. And yeah, and like the scene where the big blob is like coming out of the ground and it forms right up there. It's like this huge thing. Anyway, there's the manhole from Phantoms. What am I doing that theme for?
Someone's in here, Ben. It's Matt. Matt from Matt's Red Show. Just give me a second.
What the heck, Ben?
All right, what the hell's going on here?
Colorado, Colorado. Hey, baby. Hang out in this window often, do you? Walking in the cross section of the two main roads that walk through this village. I'm in the middle of it. Nobody cares. I'm literally standing in the middle of the town right here, and nobody cares. A little Christmas bazaar. Rent some space. Go do some Christmassy stuff.
Nearing starvation themselves said they had no food to give him.
Let's go.
Okay.
Crossing the street. Here we go. We're going doing a little shopping. Little shopping. There's the alleyway that Clint Eastwood was in. We think open. A little shopping action. Ooh. Hi there. We're shopping in Georgetown.
Thank you.
Oh, that's cool. We definitely need a magnet. We don't have a magnet.
Now that's a nice
big
truck.
Oh, we gotta get a magnet.
Yep, this is King's Lane.
King's Lane, okay.
And that's where Clint Eastwood filmed Every Which Way But Loose,
uh-huh.
And the fight scene was filmed in that alley.
Okay, the fight scene right out there. So that alley I showed you guys, that was definitely it, because I wasn't sure, but I thought
yep,
that was it.
That
cool.
Was it.
Do you remember them filming any of Phantoms here?
No.
When they did that Ben Affleck one?
Yeah, no, I don't.
Ma'am, how you doing? Much obliged.
I'm pretty good. Ma'am, how you doing, ma'am? Nice to meet you, mate.
Pretty cool. There he is. The legend. The legend.
Right behind me here, folks. Right in this little alleyway right here is where Clint Eastwood fought the biker gang.
Well, I know you. You're gone,
huh? Fought the Black Widows in this area right in here. It's pretty cool.
I saw you two, you were going for a fast freight.
Side of the alley. Oh well, at least you get to see that much of it. Here's an old store that we just walked in, folks. A lot of history here. The store's been like the same since the 1800s, and really cool. Let's go talk to one of the owners here and see what she has to say.
And do you remember? All the shelving is original.
Okay.
And the shelving matches the end of the calendar.
Oh wow.
And this has the marble on it. It's never ever been moved.
Cool. Do you remember any of the movies that have been filmed here in town?
Oh, yes.
Were you around for any of that? For the
We have the John Denver, we have the Duchess and the Dirtwater Fox.
Uh-huh.
Every Which Way But Loose.
Every Which Way But Loose. Yeah, that was right across the street, right?
Yeah.
They filmed that and do you remember Phantoms?
Yeah.
Were you a part of that?
No, my niece and nephew were part of that.
Your niece? Some of this stuff might be expired a little bit.
Go ahead and buy you out.
Kill that cold.
All right, I will.
This is on the freezer ice cream. Right now, I'm taking off. Ready to head out, hon?
Hungry, hungry, hungry.
Out into the cold night air again. Get a wide shot of this place we were just at. That was a cool little shop. She had some cool information about her store there. Right across the street from where the old Clint Eastwood folk beat some folks up. There it is. That's cool. Check it out, folks. Here's an old school Conoco station. Conoco station from the John Denver movie.
We have to have it by Christmas. Howdy.
Howdy.
Howdy. I also told him as mayor of Georgetown. The Civic emergency. See, every Christmas.
Well, as usual, I think I own more time than anyone else in town.
I got David Year's supply of Bay Road.
See if we can pick up this pretty lady standing here in the corner. Hey, pretty lady.
Yeah.
Go get some Mexican food?
Yeah.
Let's do it. Can almost picture John Denver himself playing right there. Here now, folks, at the Red Ram of Rathskeller. It is now called the Lucha. It's a cantina, Lucha. Delicious Mexican food. And Clint Eastwood fell in love with this place when he was filming Any Which Way But Loose. John Denver filmed a film, some Christmas specials here. John Denver action. Roseanne Barr, legend has it that Roseanne Barr was quite the saucy bartender during her formative years here at the, right down there, folks. Roseanne Barr might have been down there.
Downstairs, too, a bunch of people used to burn their names with candles into the ceiling. We'll go downstairs in a little bit, and I'll show you the ceiling and where people have burned their names into the ceiling. Kind of cool. And some famous people have even burned their names in the ceiling down there. Maybe we can find some. I don't know if we'll find some or not, but it's pretty cool. Pretty cool spot. And also, folks, it's supposed to be haunted. It's supposed to be a lot of ghost stories in this bar, too. It used to be called the Red Ram in the 60s, 70s, and 80s. My parents used to come here all the time on their way home from ski trips. And now I'm coming here because it's awesome. A lot of history in this bar, folks. My man rocking out here, enjoying some of his live tunes, hanging out here, doing my thing, rocking out.
I thought they were looking at me like, hey!
Oh, no. Doing a little vlogging. Got some live music. What do you have, hon?
No idea.
I'm going to have a mushroom Swiss burger. Tequila sunrise, folks. Yeah, my man rocking some tequila sunrise.
Ow!
Oh, we just got a salsa sampler. 7 kinds of salsa. Oh my gosh. It's awesome.
Look at this burger. This burger. Huge burgers. Gone. Big old burgers gone. We ate them up good.
Seriously, one of the best burgers I've ever had, man. If you live in Colorado, you can come here anytime you want. You should come here all the time. Size lie? No, this is the best burger. One of the best burgers I've ever had, man.
One of the best burgers you've ever had, too?
Oh, yeah.
So good.
This is the last bite.
Last bite. Here it goes. Going down, going down. Bam. Savor it. Savor it. Safe tonight. Fight the break of the world. Man's rocking out. Yeah. Yeah, I used to do this song. We used to rap to it. Tomorrow I'm hanging off the bar. I said a hip hop, hip hop, you don't stop a rocket to the bang bang. On down the stairs here. Get out here. Cruising on through here. This place has been here for a long time. A lot of history here. Old Red Ram people, that's about where we were sitting right there. People are hanging off the balcony. Look at that. This place is packed. All kinds of delicious food. We go down here to the Rathskeller. There's a bar down here. Restrooms down here in the basement, the Rathskeller. Go and check this spot out here. This is a place my parents used to come all the time back in the day. Apparently on the ceiling here are some names of some famous people. They burnt their names into the ceiling with a candle. Used to be all the rage back in the day, apparently. I don't know, let's see if we can find any. I don't see any.
Bob and Dale.
Wherever Bob and Dale are. It's kind of cool. Looks like Chris. It's going to be hard to find. I don't know, I'm not going to be able to tell. A little too hard. A little too hard to find the names. It's kind of cool. Alright, guys, the old Rathskeller lantern type thing. Put a candle in there. <clears throat> 1973. People have been rocking out down here in the basement since 73. Fun memories that my parents had and other people have had back in the day in the 60s, 70s, and 80s, writing their names on the ceiling with candles. Apparently, Roseanne Barr was a bartender at this place. Maybe at this one, maybe the one upstairs, I don't know. Cool. Well, we're about to head out of the Red Ram back into the cold night air. One more rock out with the gentleman out here.
Here he is. There he goes, Foo Fighters.
You still ready to go outside?
We're about to head outside. People are looking at us wondering what the hell we're doing. Filming ourselves all the time. I don't care. Doing this for you guys. Ready to go outside? Here we go.
Yep.
Into the cold again. Here we go.
Probably put the camera.
Ready? Oh, it's beautiful out.
Yeah, snow goggles.
Look at this. Oh, listen to my feet. Feet in the snow. It's so peaceful out now. So I think
head back because it's snowing.
It's snowing out. I think now is where we say goodbye. Thanks for watching this episode of Matt's Rad Show, you guys. Georgetown, Colorado. That's fun here. If you ever get a chance to come here, do it. It's a lot of fun, a lot of history. The people are really nice. They'll talk to you. They'll let you know about the history of the building they're in. Some of the movies that were shot here. John Denver Christmas specials, Clint Eastwood movies. Ben Affleck was the bomb in Phantoms, yo. So, all right, from all of us here at Matt's Rad Show, myself and Ashley, have yourself, I just farted. Have yourselves a wonderful day. And wherever you're at, yeah, have a great day, folks. Talk to you later. Georgetown, Colorado. Okay, bye. I put a little Christmas tree way up on the mountain every year.
Hey, it's like a postcard. Mm-hmm.